This flute is made by a Turkish-Egyptian maker, so it actually doesn't have the little mouthpiece on top, which a lot of you may have seen, the little round mouthpiece. And he's making these flutes, giving all my secrets. I've got lots of these beautiful days of coming to read. They're reed flutes. They're the flute that Rumi writes about as the breath of God. And the breathier the sound is really ideal. It's kind of like the silver flute, which you want a very pure sound. You want a sort of breathy sound. But he makes these flutes out of PVC pipes. And he's one of the Umar Farooq Tukla, that's who I'm referring to. He's one of the greatest players around. And he, I bought this flute from him and also a reed flute from him. He plays these when he performs and records, and I figured if he can, I can too. It's just a very solid instrument, and it's in tune, and it's pretty dependable. This is the time I referred to a minute ago when I couldn't get my long shirt to work. But the name is probably the hardest one that I've had to learn. If someone was to ask me, I would definitely say this one took me the longest to get the sound out of. It's a side lung embouchure, very unlike anything I'd done before. But it was definitely worth the effort. We're going to play the Egyptian now, Egyptian midwas. And this is a really fun trance instrument. And it's incredibly rustic how it's made, but it's amazingly powerful. So it's got this reed built into this bigger section, which is in the body. And this section is the built-in reed, so it's actually just cut out of itself. And so you don't have to have an external reed, it's actually just built within itself. And then the whole thing in your mouth, vibrations. Thank you.
Ooh.